Hello, everybody. I thought I'd go ahead and do my response video to the questions on, let's see, I did the seven question video for MD Outdoors, and I thought I'd do the response video because, you know, I said go ahead and ask questions or whatever, and I started answering those comments, and I thought, well, I'll wait and do it on camera or whatever. Let me get to this video where the questions were asked, and I'll go ahead and answer those. Let's see, my channel. Seven questions and the 22 knife. By the way, I sent that 22 knife off. Country Prepper liked it. He said it was pretty. Oh, shut up, you idiot. Okay, I'm going to run down through these comments here and we'll answer those. Check this out. You see this big old knife clamp here? I decided to make me a new one because I couldn't get really, you know, like 2-inch wide knives or whatever into this one. This is the one I've been using for the last year. And I've got somebody in mind that I was going to inherit this to or what they call it, to bequeath it to or whatever, and I'm trying to get his address, but he's not answering none of my messages or anything, and you know, I thought maybe he'd like it, and you know, maybe he's just out of town or something. Good guy, you know, I don't want to say who it is or nothing, but I kind of want it to be a surprise, but he probably knows now because I've been after him to get his email or his address. Let's see. Or some questions. Randy Parker, good old Randy Parker. He's always got some nice words to say. Thumbs up, enjoyed, and hope we all have a blessed day. Well, I hope you do too, Randy. You're a fine feller. Aaron Nelson said that if Diane cuts herself with that 22 knife, then me and her's blood brother and sister. Shovelhead 8 says it wouldn't be a Tom Chitwood knife if it didn't have a little of your blood on it, as usual. MCK says, you ain't so bad after all. Don at Southpaw Bushcraft. Great video, Tom. Love the answers. Great looking knife, too. Joseph Russell. Let's see, great on seven questions. She's going to love that knife. So how many times you buff it, and what do you buff it with? Well, then I sharpen it, and then I buff it again, so it's twice. I buff them at least twice. And sometimes I get lazy and they're crappy looking and I have to go back over them, sand them again, and buff them again. So sometimes three times, but it's usually just twice. And what do you buff with? Now, I used to buff with a pad, one of these pads right here in my drill press. But we've got a Harbor Freight in town now. Well, just the next town over. So now I've got two Harbor Freight buffers. I got them for like... with the 25% coupon, they were like $45 a piece. And I'm kind of a buffing freak. I love to buff stuff. I love the way it looks after I finish buffing. And on this, I kind of go 1, 2, 3 on the buffing. And we got this one uses the black buffing compound, which is the roughest. And then that one uses the white compound. And then the one on the far side uses this light blue compound. But the one on the far side is actually just for handles. I don't buff any metal over there. So I just use the black compound and the white compound on this side. And that's what I buff the metal with. And then whenever I buff the handle, I use that buffing wheel over there, and it has a light blue compound. And then this right here, I just stuck a wire wheel on there for cleaning rust off and stuff like that. Bluegrass Bushcraft, great video, Tom, thanks for sharing. Prep for it, good answers, thanks. Yeah, you are inspiring to many, thank you so much. Carolina Chris, watch today, you inspired me to take a lot more time wet sanding on my knife projects. Cool stuff. You inspired me to watch every time I watch. Today you've inspired me to take a lot more time wet sanding on my next knife project. Well, if you give somebody your address, they might send you a clamp that you could do some more wet sanding in. Nathan4071, good old Nathan. I love Nathan. Let's see. Good session, Tom. I enjoyed the chat. A lot of work goes into a knife. Yep. Let's see. Thanks for commenting, Nathan. Tactical Cats. I like that name. Let me go see who that is real quick. I don't know if y'all know or not. If you're friends with me on Facebook, you know I love cats. Okay, he don't have no videos. Tactical Cats. I like that name, though. Hope you have a happy new year, Tom. Thank you very much. I hope you had a good one, too. This is from Dino. Do you still work on off-road vehicles? No. I try not to work on any kind of vehicles. I was a mechanic for a lot of years, and then I built motorcycles and dune buggies and Jeeps and four-wheelers. I've done a lot of mechanic work, you know, made a living doing mechanical work, and I just totally got burnt out on it. I don't even hardly change oil in my own vehicles if I can help it anymore. Todd Parnaby, my brother from England. Well, old Tom C, where did you get your 2x72? That's an easy one. I ordered the 2x72 from Polar Bear Forge, and he sells, it's like a frame kit, and you have to provide the bolts, the motor, the wheels, and your own tool rest and stuff, which that's pretty easy for me because I've got a welder and all this, and it's a bolt together kit, but I welded mine together. It's a pretty good outfit. It takes a long time for him to deliver it because that's not his full-time job doing that, which I understand that perfectly. But it's Polar Bear Forge. He's got a website. Y'all can go check him out or whatever. The frame for my 2x72 was $115. But you can't, it doesn't have any, you can't change the wheels on it, you know, to a small wheel or the big wheel or anything. It only has a flat platen is all it's got. But it's great. It works great. Let's see, Wallace Vivian. Awesome video. I can watch your videos all day. Do you heat treat all your knives, and what steel do you use? Happy New Year. Yes, I heat treat all of my own knives. That's why I only use one steel, which is 1095 steel. And the reason why I use that is because that is the first steel that I learned how to heat treat. And it was easy enough that I could do it at home here. A lot of the other steels, there's a lot more to it. You have to be more precise with your temperatures and all that. And I did a lot of research into steels and figured out that that's the one that I wanted to go with. Fishing 523, Diane will love the knife. I love the 22 you put on it. Great video. Thanks, buddy. Cabot Bluegill. I love Cabot Bluegill too. Let's see. Good vid, Tom. I don't edit much either. Why do I want to watch my own stuff to edit when I can watch something good? I use the same type camera most of the time. Let's see. Tack Hill. The knife looks great, Tom. Putting the 22 on it was a good idea. It's interesting to hear people's answers. One question. Is that thing still? Yeah. It went damn. I didn't know if it shut off or not. That would suck. Do a big long video and it shut off. One question I have is, on a file knife, how do you soften or anneal the blade? Well, in the summertime, whenever we were having you know, fires in the fire pit out there, and family, you know, hot dog roast and all that stuff, we built a fire in the fire pit, and every time they did that, I would take every file that I was going to use for a knife and I'd throw in that fire pit and in the fire. And then I just go out the next morning and get them out of the fire pit. I dig through the ashes and find them. But what you got to do is to soften a file to where you can use it. What you do is you want to get it glowing red and then just set it out by the fire and let it cool down. Because, you know, they say, like, if you get too much heat on a knife, you're taking the temper out of it. It's the same thing with a file. If you heat it up red hot and then let it cool down, you're taking the temper out of it. And depending on how soft you want it to be, you might do that two or three times, you know. I usually just do it once because I get them really red and really hot in my forge. So, yeah. How do you soften or anneal the blade? You soften it just by heating it up red hot and letting it cool down. Brendan Barthy, the old drill looks good hanging in the back. Yeah, my papaw's drill. I actually use this too. I do, works great. I love it, I love it, I love it. I've had a lot of those rechargeable screw guns, drills, whatever. They don't last me no time. I end up tearing them up. Let's see, John Caps. Enjoyed it, Tom. Keep it up. I'm still loving my pimped out saw sheath. I need to figure out how to turn off my sub count. Somebody accused me of buying subs so I would look more popular. People are friggin' stupid, John. Not everybody, but there are some friggin' stupid people out there, John. Yeah, I turned my sub count off because I don't care, you know. I know there's folks and some good people that I'm sub to who are trying to up their count right now, and I understand that. That's fine. There's nothing wrong with that, you know, if that's what you want to do, but I don't care. You know, I don't make nothing off this. It's nice getting to talk to people, and I know people who have thousands and thousands of subs, but nobody comments on their videos, and nobody watches their videos, and, you know, so that sub count don't matter. As long as people are commenting on my videos and they're into it enough to comment, then, you know, that makes me happy. How long you been on YouTube? Well, how long is a piece of string? That's flint and steel. Let's see, you're in the South. You ever got that answer when you asked about a period of time? And I think I replied, no, I've never heard that before. I used to get that from my great uncle all the time. So one day I said, I don't know, how long is a piece of string, Uncle Devin? Too damn long was his answer. let's see, MD Outdoor Reviews. My question for your Q&A video, how did you become so handsome? I don't know. I get it from my dad, I guess. MD's crazy. He's just being funny here, buddy. Weekend hiker. Thank you for sharing, Tom. Good to get to know you, little brother. Better, brother. I'm sure Diane will love it. Take care. All the best, Adam. Thanks for watching, Adam. I sure appreciate it. Neo Wolf. Great video, Tom. Do you still have the buggy and four-wheeler you built? I still have the four-wheeler. I don't have the buggy. I gave the buggy away. But the four-wheeler is up there in my yard. It's been sitting in my backyard for 4 years now. I'd probably have to clean the carburetor out and jump it off and all that. But it was a whole lot of fun. It's a 220 Bayou rear end, a 250 Suzuki Quad Racer front end, and a 800 Suzuki Intruder street bike engine. It's all shaft drive and everything, pretty cool, liquid cooled. It's a great four-wheeler for the woods. You just put it in whatever gear you want to and you just bloop, 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 chug-a-lug around the woods. It's great. I love it. Let's see, great job on the knife and the questions. What do you charge for your knives? Well, like this Bushcraft knife right here, they're generally $90. And let's see, something smaller like this one, like I call this kind of an EDC knife or a small bushcraft knife. They're usually $75 to $80. Oh, this little fella right here. This is my newest one, my little neck knife. Get 50 out of those. Let's see. The big survival knife is 120. And you know, mostly medium-sized blades run about $90. The smaller ones are $75, and then the neck knives are $50. And then your bigger knives, like a 6-inch blade and more, they run about $120, sometimes a little more. And you take like these machetes and these big choppers and stuff like that, they can run a little higher, $140, $150. I try not to charge too much because I want everybody to be able to own whatever knife they want. The old hickory mod. Let's see. I think I got one here somewhere. Let's see. Ah, I got one already done here somewhere. Anyway, the old hickory mod. I get 25 out of those, and that's just for the knife, and I'll do whatever you want to the blade. I get 25 for those, and if you want me to make you a Kydex sheath or something for it, it's going to be an extra 25. K-bar user. Nice, Tom. I'd like to know, are you always laughing? Always makes me feel good listening to you always laughing. Stay safe, brother. K-bar user, most of the time I'm laughing, and most of the time I'm laughing. I have to laugh at myself. I have to watch and not get wound up, if that makes any sense, because I've got issues. I've got anger issues. I get mad, and I've been working on it for years, and I pretty much got a handle on it. Anger issues, because whenever I'm angry, I'm liable to do anything. And the workers at work that work, I don't want to say under me, but work the production lines at work, you know, any one of them will tell you Tom Chitwood is the nicest guy you'll ever meet in your life. He will do anything for you, but do not piss him off. You make an enemy out of Tom, and that's it. I try to laugh at myself often, and you know, sometimes I come off to myself as being stupid, because I'm like, what the, why did you do that? Oh my gosh. And to keep myself from getting mad at myself, I've got to laugh about it. You know, I got to laugh. And I got to laugh. Let's see. My buddy Mark Martin. I love Mark. I love watching inspired screw ups. Thank you, Mark. Let's see. JP Frogtack. Frogtack Sanctuary. Awesome. Thanks, JP, for watching. I got a letter from JP the day before yesterday that had one of his stickers in there, and I didn't do an opening video because I didn't know what it was, and it was just an envelope, and I opened it. I didn't even look to see who it was from, and I opened the envelope, and I was like, what in the crap? And then I realized what it was, so I didn't do it on camera. Sorry about that, JP. Let's see. Calvin's Corner. I love Calvin. Let's see. Oh, man. These got to us all, it seems. That would be cool to make a knife sheath out of the army style tent material, right? Wow, 9 years, man, you got me. Great idea. Thanks. By the way, I got this idea about reading these from Calvin. You know, reading these on camera and replying to them. Let's see. Do you hunt with detectors, and do you have any arrow points. Let's see, do you have any Civil War stuff? No, I don't have any Civil War stuff. And I don't hunt with a metal detector. It's something I've always wanted to try. And do you have any arrowheads? No, I don't have any arrowheads either. Good questions, Calvin. I have to say no to all those. Let's see, smelling roses. You're an inspiration, my friend. Keep it up. Thanks for the comment, Rashid. Great guy. Let's see, snow fog outdoors. Got Diane here. You've inspired me. Diane bought my first Old Hickory mod. We actually traded for it. I didn't want to get rid of that thing, and man, she kept aggravating me. Which it turned out good, because I ended up selling a bunch of those. And, well, I gave away more than I sold, I believe. But, anyways, that got me started in knife making. So I do attribute a lot of that to Diane, me making knives. She's a good old gal. Shalisa Shell. Let's see, I love this tag. Great job. Thanks, Shalisa. Doing it. Bushcrafter 1973. Let's see. He's going to go ahead and try to make some knives. He's got a whole lot to learn. The only way you're going to learn is by doing it, man. Bill K, great videos. Bill K's a good knife maker, too. I've got one of his knives. Country Prepper. That knife is shaping up really nice. My question is, out of all the knives you've made, which one is your favorite and or best work? I'm going to have to say Nathan4071's big gigantic chopper I made for him. That's the closest I've ever came to keeping a knife that someone bought. I had to talk myself into sending that to him. It's a big, big, beautiful knife. I mean, it was gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Let's see. Great video and tag answers, Tom. This is Tim Watson, my buddy Tim Watson. I love Tim. He's a great guy. Let's see. I'm the same way with using my name. Yep, see. I use my phone pretty much for all my videos. Flipping the camera around, you got good at guessing. Thanks, Tim. Thanks for the comment. Let's see. Cape Fear Outdoor and Survival says he's going to start trying to make a few knives. Just drop any questions you have on me, man. I'll let you know. Because if it can be screwed up, I've done it. Kevin's Adventures. I watched you sand all day. Or I could watch you sand all day. Calming. Thanks for the Mission 22 report, Diana. So lucky. Thanks for watching, Kevin. I appreciate it. Michael Williams. You seem to not know just how much you mean to others here on YouTube. Take care and God bless. Till next time, Michael. Thanks, Michael. That was so nice. Thank you. Harry Bachman. Different knife you've made. I'm also into Jeeps and things off-road. Here's my question. Do you still own the buggy you made? I answered that just a minute ago. Nope. Gave it away. Gave it to my cousin. Well, I charged him $125 for it, but I pretty much gave it away. Brandon Barthy again. Let's see. It's not about selling knives. Let's see. Great man right here. And he's not about selling knives. Trust me. I had to fight with this guy about taking my money. And then Pamela Hicks wrote, Happy New Year's. Awesome video. That's it. I expected some questions, you know, crazy questions, you know, personal questions and stuff. That's fine though, you know, if that's what you guys want to know, that's fine. Let's see. Let me throw out a weird factoid out there. I don't talk on the phone. People have tried to get my phone number and all that, and I don't talk on the phone. I don't know why. I'm a freak, but I can't talk on the phone. I just don't talk on the phone. I don't like to. I know it seems weird for somebody who likes to talk as much as I do, but I don't talk on the phone. Something about not being able to see their face while I'm talking. I don't know. It's weird. I thought I'd throw a fun, weird fact in there. Well, that's all the questions I have. If he'll send me his address, I'll send this to him. And this is my new one. I can put a full 2-inch wide blade in there. It's a half inch wider than that one. That's all I got. Got knives I'm working on. These two right here. These two knives right here are a milestone for me because I have sent knives to Canada, but these two knives here are going to Europe if I ever get them done. And that makes me an international knife maker. Well, thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll talk to you later. If y'all have any more questions, you just drop them, you know, below. I'll answer them. I don't care. I'll tell you anything. I'll talk to you later. Bye.